Ever wanted to control the brightness of your LEDs like a pro? Whether you're working on a DIY lighting project or just want smoother control over your LED, this simple circuit gives you complete power over brightness with a single twist of a knob. Hey guys, in this video, you'll learn how to build your own LED dimmer using a 555 timer. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 3 alligator clips, 8 jumper wires, a 1000 ohm resistor, a 390 ohm resistor, 2 1N4148 fast switching diodes, 2 100 nanofarad ceramic capacitors, 1 red LED, a 9-volt battery buckle connector, a 9-volt battery, 1 potentiometer, 1 555 timer IC, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and a stable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, a stable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 1000 ohm resistor. Insert a 1000 ohm resistor into pin 7 or discharge in pin 8 or VCC. Insert a 100 nanofarad ceramic capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 5 or control in a few rows below the 555 timer. Insert a 100 nanofarad ceramic capacitor in the same row as the jumper wire and the negative rail. Bend the ends of a 390 ohm resistor. Insert a 390 ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and the lower half of the breadboard. Insert a red LED in the same row as the resistor and the negative rail. The negative terminal is in the negative rail. Insert a 1N4148 fast switching diode into pin 7 or discharge in a few rows above the 555 timer. The negative terminal is in pin 7. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the diode. Attach an alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the alligator clip to the left terminal of the potentiometer. Insert a diode into pin 7 or discharge in a few rows above the 555 timer. Make sure this diode is placed in a different row from the other diode. This time, the positive terminal is in pin 7. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the diode. Attach an alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the alligator clip to the right terminal of the potentiometer. Insert a jumper wire into pin 6 or threshold. Attach an alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the alligator clip to the middle terminal of the potentiometer. Connect the 9-volt battery buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Turn the knob on the potentiometer to adjust the brightness of the red LED from 5% to 95%. Rotate the knob to the left to dim the LED brightness down to about 5%. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This is a 555 timer LED dimmer that works by pulse width modulation, or PWM. The 555 is wired as an unstable oscillator. Pin 2 or trigger and pin 6 or threshold are tied together and monitor the voltage across the timing capacitor C1. Inside the 555 there are two comparators set at 1/3 VCC and 2/3 VCC. When C1 charges up to about 2/3 of the 9-volt battery supply, the threshold comparator flips the output or pin 3 low and turns on the discharge transistor at pin 7. That transistor then discharges C1. When C1 falls to about 1/3 VCC, the trigger comparator flips the output high and turns the discharge transistor off, letting C1 charge again. This continuous charge-discharge cycle makes a square wave at pin 3 that drives the LED. The LED and its series resistor R2 are connected from the output to ground. When pin 3 goes high, current passes through resistor R2 into the LED, causing it to light up. When pin 3 is low, the LED is off. Since this switching happens hundreds of times per second, your eyes can't detect the rapid blinking. The rapid flickering blends into a steady glow, and the LED's brightness depends on how long it stays on during each cycle, called the duty cycle, rather than the amount of current flowing at any single moment. With a 9-volt supply and a typical 2-volt red LED, R2 limits the on-state current to roughly 9 volts minus 2 volts, divided by 390 ohms approximately equals 18 milliamps, which is a safe bright level for most 5mm LEDs. VR1 is a 50 kilo ohm potentiometer that, together with two 1-in-4-148 fast-switching diodes and the 1 kilo ohm resistor, lets you vary the duty cycle widely without changing the frequency very much. The diodes are connected in opposite directions around the potentiometer, so that the charging path of C1 uses one side of VR1, and the discharging path uses the other side. When the output at pin 3 goes high and the discharge transistor at pin 7 turns off, capacitor C1 begins to charge from the 9-volt supply through resistor R1, one of the diodes, and a section of the potentiometer VR1, until it reaches the voltage level at pin 2 and pin 6. When the output goes low and pin 7 turns on, C1 discharges from the C1 node back through the opposite portion of VR1 and the other diode into pin 7 to ground. Because the resistance seen by C1 while charging can be different from the resistance while discharging, the high time and low time can be adjusted independently. When you turn VR1 to one end, the charging path through the forward biased diode becomes shorter. This allows C1 to charge up to 2/3 of the supply voltage much faster, making the output stay high for a shorter period and low for a longer one. Turn it the other way and the discharge path becomes short. The output stays high much longer than it stays low. R1 provides a small fixed resistance in series with a charge path to limit current into the timing network, and to keep the duty cycle from ever quite reaching a hard 0% or 100%, which helps the oscillator remain stable. C2 from pin 5 or control to ground simply bypasses noise and stabilizes the internal 2/3 and 1/3 VCC reference levels so the duty sweep is smooth. The 555 timer produces a constant frequency PWM signal, while VR1, guided by the two diodes, adjusts how long capacitor C1 charges and discharges. This changes the duty cycle from narrow to wide, allowing the LED's brightness to fade smoothly from dim to bright. I hope this video has shown you how to make an LED dimmer with a 555 timer. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.